Welcome back to Alt Baking Bootcamp, your crash course in healthier baking. I'm Mia Rigden, nutritionist, chef, and the founder of Rasa, and today we're making chocolate peanut butter bonbons. Peanut butter is like kryptonite to me, so this recipe ranks high on my list of desserts to eat. As a mom, these are great because they're always there when the kids go to bed and they pair great with a glass of wine. So this recipe is kind of like a chocolate peanut butter cup, and it's using really simple ingredients that you probably already have in your pantry, and then we're adding some crisped rice just to add a little extra crunch and oomph to the recipe. This recipe calls for a full cup of peanut butter. That's a lot of peanut butter, but don't worry, we're gonna be making a lot of bonbons with this recipe. Each bonbon probably has less than a tablespoon of peanut butter. And peanut butter is a fantastic source of healthy fats. It's also a legume, so it's a great source of protein and it's delicious. So I like to use creamy peanut butter in this recipe because the crunch is really gonna come from the puffed rice. Dump all the peanut butter in the bowl. This is really like a dump and stir situation, which I love because it's easy. Make sure we get all of that peanut butter in here. And then our puffed rice. We're gonna do 2 tablespoons of honey. And again, we're making quite a few bonbons with this recipe. And so the amount of honey that you're getting in each one is pretty small, but it just adds the perfect amount of sweetness. And I think that honey and peanut butter is just one of those fantastic pairings. Now the coconut flour. Gonna give this, start mixing this together. I would normally lick my fingers, but that's not very COVID friendly and I wanna share these. So clean hands, guys, clean hands. This is like really gotta put some muscle into stirring this, but trust me, it's all well worth it. Okay, now that I'm seeing less of the coconut flour in there, I'm just gonna, I never measure the salt. You can measure the salt if you wanna be precise, but a few cranks of the salt shaker gets the job done. Now I'm going to grab my baking sheet with parchment paper. So we're gonna use a tablespoon to scoop out just about 1 tablespoon of dough or of the peanut butter mixture. And then I'm gonna roll them into balls. And we're gonna throw these bad boys in the freezer just to set. I think even 10 minutes would be fine, but however long you got. And then we're gonna melt some chocolate. All right, here comes the fun part. We're gonna melt the chocolate in a double boiler or bain-marie. We've covered this in a previous episode if you want a refresher. And then we're gonna dip our bonbons. I'm just gonna dump, this is about 1 cup of chocolate chips in a bowl, and I'm gonna melt this on the stove. All right, so our chocolate is pretty much melted. We've got just a little bit of hot water underneath here and the chocolate melting on top. And now I'm gonna grab the bonbons out of the freezer and we're gonna get dipping. Okay, so you're gonna wanna work quickly here because we don't want the peanut butter to start melting in the chocolate and for the bonbons to lose shape. So we're just going to use a fork to dip the bonbon in the chocolate, get it evenly coated, and then I like to kind of just shake off as much excess chocolate as possible. You can use the side, give it a little tap tap. All right, and then put it back on the baking sheet and you just repeat with all the bonbons. All right, last one here. Plenty of chocolate left over, which you could just pour onto parchment paper and throw in the fridge. Just gonna do a quick sprinkle of sea salt before we throw them in the freezer. This is really gonna accentuate the sweetness of the peanut butter chocolate bonbons. All right, put them in the freezer. I just took these out of the freezer and they look fantastic. I cannot wait to try them. As you can see, they still have the little bottom from sitting down, but it's not a huge ring, which happens when you put a little too much chocolate on. Ooh, even cuts nice. You can see there's like Rice Krisps in there, and just like a nice thin layer of dark chocolate. I'm really excited to try this. So good. All right, here we go. Mmm, it is so good. These definitely have a really strong peanut butter flavor, but the rice puffs and the coconut flour really help to fill out the bonbons a little more, so it's not so much peanut butter. These are gonna melt if you put them on the countertop, so be sure to keep them in the freezer or in the fridge in an airtight container. They will last a very long time in the freezer, and they're perfect for when you just need that little like hint of something sweet, and they taste great straight out of the freezer. Highly recommend. Thank you for watching this episode of Alt Baking Bootcamp. I hope you enjoyed it. I can't wait to hear what you think about this recipe. So make sure you're subscribed to Well and Good and leave us comments below. I wanna know what you think and if you have any questions or if there's something else you wanna see us make here on Alt Baking Bootcamp.